Do you want to convert your Kindle version into a ready-to-upload paperback 5x8 version by using Google Docs? Then watch this video. Google Docs has converted one of the most used online word processors. I think it's even more popular than Microsoft Word nowadays. But it has some limits, and my goal was to overcome this limit and to help you to format your ready-to-publish books with Google Docs. I was able to circumcise quite some issues, but not everything. And for the last issue, I'm going to jump into another program, so check it out in this video. And watch till the end, because I have some alternative solutions at the end as well. I will show you what the problem is. Normally, you can go to page setup and choose the paper size here. By default, it's letter. But for self-publishers, we don't see the 5x8 option and we don't see the 6x9 option. The best available option for us is the 5.5x8.5. But in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add a custom size option here totally for free in less than a minute. So to add the custom options, we'll go to extensions. We click on add-ons, get add-ons. And then we're going to look for the app called Page Sizer. So I've copy-pasted here. Now we see appear Page Sizer here on the top left from NetBurns. So if you click on it, we can install this. Page Sizer needs your permission, auto start installing, continue, okay. Now we have to choose our account, so I choose my default account. And now we see what we need to allow Page Sizer to do, edit, create, you just say allow. And now you see Page Sizer is installed. Now we have the extension added. First, I'm going to update the table of contents. What's running, I copy pasted the Word document into this Google Doc and the page breaks are gone. So always check for each chapter or at the end of each chapter, you want to add a page break for the paperback. But now we're going to update the table of contents. So what I'm first going to do, I'm going to select the table of contents, which was generated for the ebook version. We're going to replace it by the table of contents of for the paperback with page numbers. So I clicked on insert and I scroll down and I see table of contents and I click the dotted version. And when I click, it's going to generate a new table of contents with all the page numbers. So if you do any updates after adding this table of contents, make sure you go to the table of contents before you exported this document and upload it on Amazon. Make sure you always click on the table of contents and choose update table of contents so that the page numbers point to the right position in the book. And now we want to add the page numbers to this document. So I go to insert, I select page numbers, and then you can click, for example, if you want the page numbers down like me, you can click this image. You see that the first page is empty. So select this one because I don't want the page numbers to appear on the title page. I want them to appear from here on. And now you see page number one on this page. I want this to be page number two. So I have to go to format page numbers, header, footer. Now footer, show on first page, no, start at one. If I do apply, now you see that this page is page number two. This is page number one, the title page, it's only not shown. Different first page options, so that's cool. Okay, and now we've added the page numbers, but I want them in the middle. So I select them, I go to format, align and indent, and I click on center here. So I click on center, and now the page numbers are always in the middle of the page. So what we're going to do now is update the margins first. So we go to file, page setup, update margins, and you can do, for example, 1.76 four times. It's important that we update the margins now, because if we later click on OK, the paper size will be reverted back to the paper size selected here. So we have to always update the margins first. And Google Docs doesn't have a gutter margin, which is important for printing. And I will explain what the gutter margin is, and I will show you how you can add that in the PDF file later. But now we click on OK. So now it's finally time to update the paper size to 5x8. So we click on extensions, and we've added the page sizer add-on here. And we set the page size by clicking here. And we select a custom page size. Make sure you have selected inches. You can also do it in millimeters or points, but we want to do it in inches. And we do the width 5 and the height 8. And then we click OK. And now you want to check the whole document if everything is formatted OK. So we go to File, Download as a PDF, and we click here. And now the whole document is resized to 5x8. Okay, after downloading it, I opened the PDF in Adobe Acrobat, but unfortunately we cannot change the gutter here. We need to use the 7-day free trial to make the changes. But I have an alternative for you to totally skip Google Docs without investing in the Microsoft Office subscription. I will continue with the 7-day free trial to show you how you can update the gutters, and I will link a new video at the end of this video. I've successfully installed the full version, the free trial of Adobe Acrobat, where I can edit PDF documents. So you can click on All Tools and then click on Organize Pages. And what you want to click on next is Set Page Boxes. And here you see already sizes and change page size. What we want to do, we want to add gutter to the even and odd pages in different ways. So instead of using fixed sizes, we're going to use custom. And here we fill the original size of the book, which is 5 by 8. And now comes the fun part. Here we use the offset. I click off center off. Offset, I use 0.36 inches. And I want to apply this to all pages, but here only to the odd pages. I'll show a picture of a book right now on the screen. You see that the title and subtitle page where the author name is displayed, it starts on the right of the book. So what we want to do is that the text, we want to offset it to the right. So all the odd pages, we need to offset a little bit to the right. So now I've put in 0.36 inches and I click OK, and it will apply to the whole document, all the odd pages. And now here you already see that this is put in a little bit more to the right. And now I click on Set Page Boxes again. I click on Custom. I put in the original size of the book. And what we want to do now, we want to do minus 0.36 inches. We'll do that for all the pages, but only the even pages this time. Now we'll click on OK. Now you see a little shift to the left for the even pages. So let me show you here. So now we are on the two-page view. Normally the title page starts here, and this page, page 2, is displayed here. So now it's a little bit different, but now you will see you have more margin in the middle, so it's easy. So the gutter is implemented the right way. Now you can save this file and upload it to KDP. Of course, you always want to use the previewer in KDP when you upload your file to see if everything is correct. Well, to be honest, I'm not happy with this solution because you need a free trial of Adobe Acrobat Reader. For after 7 days, you need to pay, and it's really expensive. A Microsoft Office suite at the end with Excel, PowerPoint, all the good stuff is cheaper than paying for one Adobe Acrobat license. So you can do that, or you can check out the service below. Or I will make a new video with LibreOffice, which is totally free, which is like Google Suite or Microsoft Office Suite, similar, but something open source, which you can download and install on your Mac and PC for free. I will make a video how to format your book as a 5x8 paperback or 6x8 paperback as well. So subscribe to my channel if the video doesn't show up here yet. And otherwise, click on this video to watch how you can do it for free. See you in the next video, guys. Bye-bye.